History burns in the minds and souls of Ulstermen. Flames temper the faith. In the midst of a troubled present, the past must still be celebrated with street bonfires and huge marches. For the Catholic minority, it is a testing time. For the Protestants, it is both a carnival and an affirmation. Some compare it with Guy Fawkes Night in England, and it would all be just good fun if prejudice in Ulster did not burn as fiercely as the bonfires. But the youngsters know what it is all about.
He's important to us, yes.
Yes, he is. Doubly important. A good day, fraud.
Do you really care about that, though? I mean, you know, in England there aren't any kids who care about King Billy, you know?
Well, my father does it, so I do it. I take after my father. See him here. He fought for Ulster and he landed in Kelly Fergus, you know?
Yes.
You know?
Then he won the ball of a boy.
Then what did he do?
Won a ball of a boy.
Yes.
That glorious revolution.
Yes. That's what I said, but they wouldn't believe me.
Oh, no.
I'm getting burnt to death here. What about Catholic kids?
Because their fathers were fighting against us, and we fight against them.
They teach our kids to fight against us, but...
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
They teach our children to fight against us. Huh? Teach them how to make petrol bombs.
When the army came into Belfast, they brought all the Catholics down to camp, train them how to shoot guns and all, but they wouldn't bring floods.
Would you like to live in peace in Ireland?
Yes. It doesn't matter to me.
Why doesn't it matter to you?
Sure, if your house is going to get burnt, it's going to get burnt.
I'd rather have peace, because then you have no destruction. But when it all starts fading, everybody get put out of work and there'll be no money, then there'll be starvation all over the place.